Want to speak real German from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at GermanPod101.com.
How to get a return on your language learning investment. I'm learning a language, but I'm not sure if it's working or if I'm getting better. Have you ever felt this way? This is a very normal thought to have. But before you go and blame your textbook or your app, let's make sure you're not the one making mistakes. So let's get into part one. You already know the first big reason if you've watched our previous monthly reviews. People often fail because they set vague goals, like I want to be fluent, which they don't know how to achieve. But the second big reason is lack of time. They don't put in the hours. Learning a language is a lot like going to a gym. You get what you put in. For example, if you get a dumbbell and do nothing, nothing happens. It can do great things for you, but it won't work until you pick it up and curl it a few times. The same thing goes for whatever language learning resource you're using or not using. If you put in 1 hour a day, you get results. If you put in 10 minutes a day, you get results. But if you put in zero, you get zero. You can have the best language learning method in the world and get zero results if you do nothing. And similarly, you can have the worst textbook ever and make progress if you put in the time. So you have to make sure you're consistently putting in time first. Part two, getting a return on language learning. Now, if you're putting in time and have a consistent routine, the next step is to track your effort and results. There's a good quote for this. What gets measured gets managed, meaning if you track your progress, you can know what works and what doesn't, and you know how to improve. So, let's say your dream is to speak the language, and right now you're using a quiz app to learn the language. How do you know if it's working? You can waste months doing this until one day you realize you can't speak. Or you can figure this out sooner if you track your effort. If you step back and track your effort and results, you'll see that the quizzes have helped you remember words, but you've done zero speaking practice and can't speak. Once you realize this, you can adjust your routine to do something else that helps you speak. The point is, you get to know what works and what doesn't work. Again, what gets measured gets managed. Next, tracking helps you see a clear path to your language goals. Here's an example from our learning program. With our audio lessons, the absolute beginner level ones, we know that 3 or 4 audio lessons can help you master about 1 minute of conversation. That's because the dialogue tracks are about 20 seconds. So 20 seconds apiece, that's 60 seconds, 1 minute. Now you know the return on your time. 3 or 4 lessons means 1 minute of conversation. And because you know how to reach 1 minute, you know how to reach 2 minutes, 3 minutes, and then 10 minutes. You can actually see a clear path to your goals. So the big lesson is, if you track your results, you'll know what to expect in the future, and you can hit your language learning goals. Again, what gets measured gets managed. Now, how do you track exactly? Part three, how to track your results and hit your goals. Remember, at the basic level, language learning is putting in time. You don't need a special language gene or a talent. You just need time. The more time you put in, the more results you get. So let's look at two ways, an easy way and an advanced way of tracking your time and results. Let's start with the easy way first. One, simply track the time you put in. So if you do a 10-minute audio lesson today and then spend 5 minutes with flashcards, note this as 15 minutes for the day. Just write it down in a notebook or a planner. Then do the same thing tomorrow. The goal here is to track the time and your effort so you can review later. If one day you realize you don't speak as much as you'd like, here's what you do. You look at your timesheet. If you see that you've been just watching YouTube videos, you can spot the problem, which is you've done no actual vocab study or speaking practice. And then you can start doing it. Another way you can track your time and effort is with the dashboard on our site. If you visit the dashboard, you can see the lessons you've completed, the number of flashcards reviewed, and hours studied. Now, here's the second tactic, and it's an advanced one. Track time and results. Tracking time is easy, but tracking results is trickier if you're learning a language on your own. So, how do you do that? For example, if you're studying words with flashcards, study for 5 minutes and can remember 7 out of 10 words, then that's your return. You know that 5 minutes gives you 7 words. If you know this, you'll know what to expect when you learn new words. Another thing you can do is work to boost that number to 10 out of 10. Next, if you're practicing your listening skills, try to gauge how much you understand. If you understood about 20% of a 3-minute lesson, then that's your return for now. But by knowing this, you can start asking questions like, what can I do to understand 50% of this lesson? Will doubling my time double my results as well? Will reviewing this lesson for a few minutes a day every day work better than trying to memorize it all today? Then you put these questions to the test and try them out. And because you know your return, you can see if it really works. The three powerful language learning lessons you'll pick up at the gym. The first lesson is how to approach your goals and language learning. So, why are we talking about the gym? The gym is a great example because it's filled with people working on their goals, and it gives you a snapshot of where most people are with their goals. And everyone there has one goal, to be fit. But not everyone is there yet. You have a few people that look like fitness models. Then you have around 20 or 30 people that have good, respectable physiques, the middle group. And then the rest of the people are still working their way up. It's motivating because everyone has a chance of succeeding. If you've been to the gym, you understand the importance of repetition, doing reps. A rep is the number of times you do a certain exercise. Like 15 push-ups is 15 reps of push-ups. So even people still working toward their goals have a chance of succeeding if they put in the reps. If they do a little bit a day over a long period of time, they'll get there. The process is simple. The more you do, the longer you stick with it, the more progress you make. And the same goes for learning language or any other goal in life. It's about putting in the reps a little bit a day, consistently, for a long period of time. If you want to get bigger muscles, you pick up a dumbbell and you do reps. If you want to learn more words, you do the reps. 5 new words a day. So, what can you do right now? For example, if you're using our program, just do one lesson a day. If you have a textbook, do one page a day. If you're using an app, put in 5 minutes a day. Again, everyone has a chance to succeed. They just need to put in the reps, and they need to make the time. This is where the second lesson comes in. You'll learn how to find and make time to learn a language. There's a reason the people you see at the gym daily, and especially the people you see at 10 p.m. on a Friday, are the ones with above average results. They're the most consistent. But how do they get that level of consistency? There tend to be 3 types of people. First, the people that have plenty of free time, so it's a non-issue for them. Second, the busier people. They make time regardless of what their schedule is like, meaning they show up at 1 a.m. just to fit in a session, or they cancel other plans to make time. And third, the people who have made it a habit. They're so used to going that they don't have to think about it. Ideally, you want to be in the third group with language learning. But most people fall into the second group. The truth is that to make time, they have to cancel other plans. Some wake up earlier to squeeze in a session in the a.m. Some go late at night. It's the same exact thing with language learning. You make time. The good news with language learning is you don't need to open up a lesson at 1 a.m. and put in an hour. With our learning program, you'll get our quick but powerful 3 to 15 minute audio and video lessons. And because the lessons are short, you can easily make time. You can do a lesson on your commute or while walking somewhere. Imagine learning a quick conversation while on your way to the store. Finally, the third language learning lesson you'll learn at the gym is why you don't need the best possible routine to get results. Have you ever heard a friend say, "I have to start the right way. It has to be perfect." Well, this is a disastrous way to start anything, whether fitness or language learning. And most learners spend a lot of time worrying about starting right, instead of just starting and keeping at it. But the point is, if you start learning from a textbook and stick with it, you'll get results. You'll improve your reading, vocabulary, and grammar. Of course, it won't get you speaking. You'll only get good at what you focus on. But the fact is, you'll still make progress. Same with the gym. If you start off with bicep curls, you'll see progress in time. But at some point, you'll need to add in legs as well. You can't skip leg day. So here's what you can learn. Here's what smart beginners do. They don't look for the best way to start. They just start and keep going. And once they have a consistent routine, they start optimizing. They improve their routine. If you start taking one lesson a day and can easily maintain that routine, then you might eventually realize that you want to practice speaking. You need to shadow that lesson's conversation. So you add shadowing to your routine, and that's how you grow. Same thing with the gym. the smart beginners make sure they do their reps and come in as much as possible. And doing the basics is enough for them to build muscle. Later on, they'll start adjusting their exercises and adding new ones. But you'll never get to that point if you overthink yourself into inaction and don't build that habit. So as long as you start and continue, most starting routines and learning methods are good enough. You don't need the best possible one right now. You could have the best possible language learning program, but if you don't use it consistently, it's useless. All right, so today you learned 1, how to approach your goals, 2, how to find time to learn a language, and 3, why you don't need the best possible routine or learning program. If you're like most language learners, then your number one goal is to speak more, right? You want to have fluent conversations with natives. It's a great goal to have. But for most language learners, speaking also happens to be their weakest skill. You may not know enough of the language to express yourself. You tend to run out of words and things to say. And you're just not sure how to start conversation. If you have at least one of these issues, then talking points are just what you need. Part 1. What's a talking point? A talking point is a topic that invites discussion or argument. In other words, just something to talk about. It could be about yourself, your work, your hobbies, the weather, food, or what you did this past weekend. All of these are talking points. Here's an example to help you better understand talking points. Think of a conversation you'd have with a friend. You can ask, "What did you do this weekend?" They'll reply and then ask you back. The talking point here is the weekend. Let's say your friend says they went to a restaurant. That's a natural talking point to explore next. You can ask, "What kind of restaurants do you like?" Now you've covered 2 talking points. The more talking points you have, the more you can speak. And the same goes for your target language. The only challenge is you need to know the relevant words and phrases for that topic. For example, if you want to talk about the weekend, you need to know phrases and questions like, "What did you do this weekend?" "I did this." "What about you?" In the next part, you'll discover 5 easy talking points that you can master with our learning program. Let's get into part 2. Part 2. 5 talking points you can use. The first one is, learn how to introduce yourself in your target language. Why is this a powerful talking point? Introducing yourself is something you'll do again and again, every time you meet someone new. So learning the relevant phrases is a must. If you've done the first few lessons on our site, you can already do this. If not, then check out our Absolute Beginner lessons and the Top 25 Questions You Must Know lessons. You'll learn basic conversations with our quick 3 to 15 minute lessons. We'll give you the exact lines to use, along with the translations, so that you can use them in conversations. You can also use this talking point to continue a conversation. For example, if you've started with a different point, like the weather, then it makes sense to say, "By the way, my name is..." Talking point number 2, the weather. This is a universal talking point. People like to talk or complain about the weather all over the world. In fact, just saying, "It's really nice today," is enough to start a conversation with a native speaker. If you want to talk about the weather, check out our Can-Do lesson pathway called Can Talk About Weather. You'll find this pathway in the absolute beginner level of our lesson library. Talking point number 3, compliments. Compliments are another great way to start a conversation or continue one. If you're running out of things to say, you can quickly transition and say something about their city, their country, or just, "Hey, I like your shirt." If you want to learn how to compliment, check out our compliments phrase list. This list is free to access for all users. If you don't know where to find it on our site, leave a comment in the comments below and we'll follow up. Point number 4, ask for help. For example, you can ask for directions or about the price and let the conversation go from there. These are very basic phrases that you learn in our survival phrases lessons. If you want to strike up a quick dialogue, this is a great talking point to use. Point number 5, learn phrases for transactions, like getting a room at a hotel, shopping, ordering food, or telling the taxi driver where to go. You may think that this isn't much of a talking point, but for the learners that are shy about talking to random native speakers for no reason, this is an easy way to start a dialogue. You have a good excuse. You want to buy something, so the staff will be happy to respond. Again, you learn all of these with our survival phrases lessons. Okay, let's move on to our last part. Part 3, how to get our conversation cheat sheets. Lastly, I'm going to tell you how to get our collection of conversation cheat sheets for free. With these cheat sheets, you'll be able to talk about all kinds of topics: travel, hobbies, dating, family, weather, and much more. Which means you can master a lot of talking points and speak more of your target language. If you'd like to get these cheat sheets, please leave us a comment in the comment section. 4 rules for staying motivated with language learning. Want to know how to really stay motivated? Then listen closely to these 4 rules. These rules might be a little different from the advice that you often hear. Ready? Rule number 1, action comes first. Are you the type of person who prefers to make things happen? Or are you the type that waits for things to happen to you? One of the best ways to stay motivated with language learning is to not think about motivation. Instead, take action and start learning. The mistake that most people make is that they have this backwards. They think they should wait to feel motivated first and then start learning. But really, it's the other way around. First, you do a language lesson. You learn a basic conversation. Then you do another. And then you start feeling like you can do more and learn more. You see results. So results bring motivation. Thinking about motivation does not bring motivation. Thinking about motivation is like reading an article about how to go outside for a run instead of actually going outside for a run. So action comes first. Rule number 2, always have an outside influence. It's very easy to lose motivation if you're learning language alone. So what do you do? Here are some examples. You get a study buddy. You hire a tutor. You join a meetup group. You plan a trip to a country where people speak that language. Or you sign up for a proficiency test, like many language learners do. Why do this? Because now you have other people depending on you. You have outside factors that keep you going with the language. For example, if you signed up for a language proficiency test, you know you have a few months to study and you have to take the test on a certain date. Someone is going to pass or fail you. This is a lot more motivating than learning alone. If you're learning with our program, you can get your own teacher with the Premium Plus plan. They'll hold you accountable, send you homework, and give you feedback. If you have a study buddy, well, now you have someone that expects you to show up and improve. And if they're better than you, that should give you extra motivation because you want to be at their level. So get some outside influence. The next rule is rule number 3. Always have a go-to study method. When you arrive at work or the gym, or when you start your homework, you always have that one thing you do first, right? What do you do? For example, with work, maybe the very first thing you do is check emails. Then you check your tasks for the week. After that, you get started. Well, you need to make the same kind of habits with language learning. You need a go-to study method that you're comfortable with, an easy starting point. And this totally depends on you and your style. Choose something you enjoy. Some people listen to audio lessons. Some people like flashcards. For some people, writing is easy. You can write out song lyrics and translate them. It's up to you. The point is, you should give yourself an easy first step to get you started and get into the flow of learning. If you're learning with our program, you can start with the word of the day email or do a quick 3-minute audio lesson. You can copy out the lesson dialogue, read through the lesson notes, or even easier, just review and re-listen to a lesson you took the day before. If you have your own go-to study method, you're already miles ahead of most learners. Leave a comment and tell us about it. And finally, rule number 4, always be working on something. So here, I want you to stop and think about your friends. Do you have a friend that's always up to something? Some project? They're working on a song, or they're making videos. They finish one thing and they start another. Well, if you wonder how they stay motivated, it's because they're always working on something. And this goes back to taking action. If you're not learning or working, you can't stay motivated. So you need to apply this to language learning. How? For example, like I mentioned in part 2 about outside influence, you can make a plan to travel to a country that speaks your target language. Or you can sign up for a language proficiency test. If you do that, you'll have something to look forward to, something to do. If you're traveling, you need to learn travel phrases. If you have a proficiency test coming up, you have to study grammar and do exercises. What else can you do? If you already have a textbook or workbook, make it a goal to finish that book. If you have a learning program, make it a goal to finish it or reach a certain level. If you're using our lessons, make it a goal to finish one learning pathway. Then, when you're done, give yourself something else to do, something to stick with, something to look forward to. So, let's recap. 1, action comes first. 2, always have an outside influence. 3, always have a go-to study method. And 4, always be working on something. How to double your speaking time in your target language. Okay, let's get into part 1. Why is real speaking progress so hard to make? Let's say you've studied the language for a few months, and now you finally have a chance to practice speaking. Maybe you have a tutor or a native speaker friend who is willing to practice with you. You start talking, and your friend helps you improve bits and pieces of your speaking, like pronunciation and grammar. And maybe you can talk about your day and common topics. But without proper preparation on both sides, the person learning and the person teaching, that's it. You're limited to what you can talk about. You don't know enough of the language to keep going, and they aren't prepared to help you speak more of the language. So if you try to have an open-ended conversation, you'll fall flat at some point. You'll run out of things to say and talk about. You'll run out of words and topics. And this is true outside of language learning. It's easy for conversations to die when you run out of things to talk about. A freestyle approach to conversation is nice for advanced learners or people who do serious preparation, but it's not so great for beginners. This is one reason it's hard to make real progress with speaking. You run out of things to say. But there is a way to double your speaking time, even if you're an absolute beginner, even if you're low on words and grammar. And that's by adding structure that you'll find in our lessons. Let's get into that. Part 2, how you can double your speaking time with our audio and video lessons. Let's say you're having a practice conversation with that same friend. Except this time, both of you have a list of topics to follow. Then, your conversations won't die out as quickly. The point is, if you have a structure to follow, like a lesson, there's always something for you to fall back on. And if you're already using our audio and video lessons, you get just that. So here's how you can use our lessons to double your speaking time. 1, make sure to listen to and review your current audio or video lessons. Why? Each lesson conversation is based on a certain topic, like talking about the weather, talking about family, ordering food, and so on. So by simply taking a lesson, you learn a conversation around a certain topic. Lessons will give you a lot of topics to talk about, along with the relevant grammar and vocabulary, which many beginners might not have. Think about it. If you wanted to talk about a vacation, you'd need to know words like vacation, cruise, and holiday in your target language. You'd also need the right grammar points to help you express ideas. Our audio and video lessons will provide you with all of these, so listen to the lessons and prepare ahead of time. 2, use the dialogue presented in the lesson. In other words, you can memorize the lines from the lesson dialogue. You're already learning conversations in the lesson, so you may as well use them for yourself. And doing this will help prepare you for future conversations. Think about it. We often use lines like, where are you from? What's your name? My name is, how was your weekend? I went out last weekend. Once you memorize these expressions, you can and will use them over and over. As an example, imagine you do a few lessons about the weather. You'll master a few conversations about it. The next time that topic pops up in real life, you'll be able to talk about it. And 3, each lesson comes with cultural insights. What does that mean for you? It gives you more things to talk about with a native speaker. So if you bring up a cultural point in a conversation with a native speaker, you'll likely get a good reaction and extend the conversation because you're talking about what they know best, their culture. So today you learned 1, why it's hard for many learners to make progress with their speaking skills. It's because we tend to run out of things to say. And 2, how you can double your speaking time. Accomplish this by taking our lessons, memorizing the dialogues, and using the cultural insights. Want to speed up your language learning? Take your very first lesson with us. You'll start speaking in minutes and master real conversations. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Just click the link in the description.